It's no secret that car thefts have just shot up in recent years, both here and across our country. So tonight we want to talk about some of the progress that's actually being made, because according to a new national report, one of our Twin Cities saw the theft trend turn around in a huge way. Kent?
Hey, Jana, it's no secret that there has been a huge jump in car thefts. It started a couple of years ago when social media posts exposed security flaws in Kia and Hyundai vehicles. And those went viral, especially among teens. But that the way that the St. Paul leaders and Ramsey County leaders responded has set them apart.
Of all the crime trends that the Council on Criminal Justice tracks, motor vehicle theft is by far the most consistent, and not in a good way, rising 105% nationally since 2019, which is what makes St. Paul so intriguing. Of all 34 cities tracked last year, St. Paul was the biggest outlier, seeing auto thefts drop by 39% in 2023. And so far in 2024, St. Paul police say that trend continues.
We're already seeing a 33% reduction in our auto thefts this year. That equates to 80 less people that have had their car stolen so far in 2024.
Sergeant Mike Ernster credits a three-pronged approach that begins with prevention efforts in the hardest hit neighborhoods.
We're going into those areas and we're very intentional about talking to these victims. Some of these auto thefts are crimes of opportunity. So we want to remove that opportunity, talk to them about what's going on in their neighborhood so that they can talk to their neighbors also.
But the communication doesn't stop there.
It's really not that complicated. We actually know who a lot of these kids are.
Ramsey County Attorney John Choi says early intervention with young people is the second prong, and says a key grant from the Department of Commerce in 2021 helped make it possible.
We don't want just more prosecutors. We don't want just more cops. We also want community navigators to be a part of the solution, and we want to figure out ways to engage families. And I think that's a big part of why some of the good outcomes are happening.
Which brings us to the third prong.
Without the arrests, we can't do the intervention and prevention.
Ramsey County Undersheriff Mike Martin says focused enforcement alongside St. Paul Police has also helped them clear or solve more cases at a time when the rates nationally since 2019 have seen steep declines.
If St. Paul is engaging in a program that is directed at youth, that could be promising.
Research analyst Ernesto Lopez says all you have to do is compare St. Paul's rates to Minneapolis last year, which saw auto thefts jump by 26%, according to the same report.
Just as someone that's watching these numbers and these trends, is that surprising?
It is somewhat surprising, but it may not be surprising if certain strategies in St. Paul are effective and they are displacing vehicle thefts. So if people are moving, who are committing these crimes, are moving from St. Paul to commit those crimes in Minneapolis, that wouldn't be surprising.
We have definitely seen some displacement over to Hennepin County because the offenders know that here in Ramsey County, we are working on them. We know who they are. They will be held accountable. But we have seen Hennepin County and Minneapolis now have reached out to us, and we're starting to work with them more closely. And I have a feeling we'll be able to reduce metro-wide auto thefts.
And on that last point, it does appear Minneapolis is now seeing progress, at least more recently. According to the very latest data from the city's crime dashboard, car thefts are down by nearly 27% since this point last year. But keep in mind, the auto theft rate in Minneapolis is still more than twice as high as it is in St. Paul, according to that national report. So there's a long ways to go there, Jana.
Right. When you look at the data that you looked at and that any of our viewers can look at to see how high it had been, you know, it's going to take a while to come down, and hopefully it does.
Yeah. Thanks. And it's really interesting because St. Paul and Minneapolis historically have been kind of on even footing. So the fact that they've got this big discrepancy now is something everyone wants to come up with a solution to.
Interesting. Thanks so much, Kent.